Henry the Big Greed Engine had been working very hard. The goods work had increased, and his trains had become longer and heavier. Neville and Murdoch and Hank tried their best, but they couldn't handle the extra work on top of their own. Carrying these extra goods trains is getting too much. Not even my 10 wheels can make it with all this rush. I handled heavy goods in my old days. Lots of goods trains at once is becoming exhausting. The three heavy goods engines, as well as Henry, agreed that it was clear that another engine was needed for extra help. One evening, Henry was backing down to his train when he saw the fat controller waiting for him. "Hello, Henry. As you know, goods work has been putting a lot of stress on you and the others."
"Indeed, sir. We also talked about getting help.
So that's why I bought a new engine to help with the extra work. He also will be assisting on regular passenger trains when he's needed." Henry was pleased.
"Thank you, sir. When is the new engine coming?"
"He has arrived today. He'll be waiting for you at Vickerstown." And with that, the fat controller left, and Henry set off with his goods. As he went along the main line, he was eager to meet the new engine.
"I wonder what he looks like."
"We'll have to find out, old boy." Soon, Henry arrived at Vickerstown. He looked all around, hoping to spot the new engine.
"Hello!"
Henry looked up. There, standing nearby, was a very strange-looking engine. He had six large wheels, painted orange, and a big tender on his back.
"Hello there. My name is Henry. You must be the new engine."
"Yes, I am. My name is Vulcan."
"Nice to meet you, Vulcan. I say, you're such a sight to see. I never saw an engine like you before. Are you a steam engine?"
"Thank you, but no. I'm not a steam engine. Even though I look like one, I'm a diesel."
Henry was puzzled.
"How?"
"I'm an experimental engine. As a prototype of the gas turbine, my tender carries the fuel where I carry kerosene. A strange source of fuel, but that's what I use instead of ordinary diesel fuel."
Henry was impressed.
"Well, that's interesting. In that case, welcome to the railway. Let's go to the sheds."
Vulcan was quickly introduced to the other engines. They all greeted him warmly, but Gordon and James didn't. They looked at Vulcan all over, taking note of the shape of steam engine and diesel power.
"Is that what he is? A diesel in the shape of a steam engine? That doesn't seem normal."
"It's awkward to me. And that kerosene fuel he uses, not such a normal fuel if you ask me."
"The fat controller is giving Vulcan his fuel depot. That's why he can be loaded whenever he needs it.
But still, he's the most awkward engine I've ever seen."
Henry looked at Vulcan sympathetically.
"Take no notice about those two. They're always like this when new engines arrive. Don't take it seriously. They'll get used to it."
Vulcan just sighed. The next morning, Vulcan was set to work on his first goods train. He was enjoying himself, and the trucks were very well behaved.
"This is the smoothest ride we've ever had."
Vulcan smiled. Then he saw Gordon passing by with the express and tooted his horn. But Gordon didn't whistle back. Later on, he saw James at Ellsbridge and tooted his horn again, but like Gordon, James didn't respond. Later that day, he was taking some trucks back to Knapford. Vulcan saw Gordon and James at Kronk Station. He tooted his horn once more, but this time, the only response he got was an angry hiss of steam from both engines. Henry and Edward were talking in the yards when a sad Vulcan pulled in.
"Hello, you must be Vulcan. My name is Edward. How was your day?"
Vulcan didn't say anything. He was uncoupled from the trucks and whirled sadly away.
"That's odd. He was very cheerful this morning."
"I think something happened. We better talk with him later."
That night, Vulcan was sleeping alone in a shed next to the big station. Just then, Henry and Edward jumped in.
"Vulcan, is something wrong?"
"I can tell by your expression that something happened to you. What's the matter?"
Vulcan knew that saying nothing wouldn't solve anything, so he told the two engines that Gordon and James were being rude to him.
"I don't know why they treat me like this. I never did anything to them. I think it's because of my design.
They need more time to get used to someone new, especially to a crossover of a steam and a diesel engine."
"I know. But their treatment brought back dreadful experiences that I once had back on the mainland. It seems the story repeats again."
"What are you talking about?"
"When I came out of the factory, I proved to be successful. I could pull passengers as well as freight. But that didn't mean there weren't problems. The other diesel engines made fun of me, calling me awkward and ugly. Some of the steam engines were kind to me, but some would scowl at me.
sometimes calling me an imposter. Edward and Henry were shot. Even after my trials, I was only in service for 4 years. The timetables were long, with engines turning around in turntables and coupled up to the rear of the train. The diesel engines didn't have problems with this, so I was withdrawn from service. But luckily, I was saved by the National Railway Museum and started doing rail tours. The other engines helped me to move on, but I thought some engines like them were wiser these days. I understand what you have been through. You know, Henry can tell you from his experience.
Indeed. You see, I wasn't like this when I first came to Sodor. I was also a hybrid engine too, with a small firebox that couldn't make so much steam. I was so nearly close to being replaced. But thankfully, the factory director at the time gave me another chance by using Welsh coal. It was expensive, but it allowed me to build some more steam.
Wait, it was expensive?
Yes, it was. But Henry felt better after that, and his hard work paid for the factory director's help.
Gordon and James teased me about my condition, but with time we became good friends.
Let those two be themselves. They will see what's coming back to them.
Vulcan smiled. Edward and Henry's words reassured them, and the three engines continued talking for the rest of the night. The next morning, he was taking empty trucks to Wellsworth. As he was nearing the signal gantry, he saw a guard waving his red flag.
Sorry, but the engine has a burst safety valve. We need to get them moving to leave the line clear for the express.
Vulcan looked ahead of the train. It was James who had broken down. He knew James had been rude to him, but he simply couldn't leave him in the middle of the line.
Sure thing. I'll move him.
Very well, then. Let's hurry.
So Vulcan was coupled in front of James and moved him out of the way. Soon the line was clear. Gordon thudded by with the express.
It was nothing. No need to thank me.
James remained silent, but James wasn't the only one to have problems. As Gordon steamed along, he felt the weight of his coaches getting heavier and heavier.
Something is not right. We need to stop.
The driver did so, and brought the train to a halt. As the guard explained the situation to the passengers, Gordon's crew expected his tender. The problem wasn't hard to find.
Your brake pipes have failed. We can't keep the brakes of the coaches off. Bother! Now what?
Suddenly, he heard a familiar horn from behind. It was Vulcan with James in his train. He came to a quick stop right beside Gordon's train.
Gordon's brake pipes have failed. We can't go any further. I can help. I'll keep the brakes off on the coaches. The only wait I'm having is James and our trucks.
All right, then. We mustn't keep the passengers waiting.
Vulcan was coupled up to the express, and the guard connected the brake pipes.
Ready when you are.
Gordon blew his whistle, but he didn't speak. With a mighty whir of his engine, Vulcan moved the long cavalcade to the next station. As they were passing Crosby, passengers and engines at the platform cheered at Vulcan as he rolled slowly but surely. Edward and Boca were at the station. They cheered as Vulcan came in, and the passengers cheered too.
Well, it seems an awkward engine had to put two silly big engines in their place.
Gordon and James were out of words. The two engines were shunted into the sidings and waiting to be taken to the works. Boca took over the express, and Vulcan looked after James's trucks. That evening, Vulcan came to visit Gordon and James at the works.
We're sorry for calling you an awkward engine. It was a shame for us.
You did a great job helping us out. You managed to pull our trains with us, too.
It was nothing. I know you were rude to me before, but I couldn't leave you stranded with your trains. Besides, it was something that Henry said. In emergencies, trains must get through.
Gordon and James happily agreed. Now, Vulcan is an official member of the Northwestern Railway. When James and Gordon came back from the works, they became good friends. The other engines don't think he's awkward anymore. They think he's the most unique engine on the whole island. Vulcan is glad to have new friends and a new home on the island of Sodor.